200 lap Governor's Cup here in November. After that race, we'll tear this place up, repave it. If you think these cars are fast now, just wait till next February. Daytona Dodge American Auto Pace Car getting ready to pull off 19 strong for this year's Orange Blossom. James Lynch, that blue 76, inside of Stephen Massey. Here we go, off of turn four. We are underway in 3-1 already. Gee, we're hearing a thought about it. Oh man, up the track goes the 76 and 51. Who's going to get the break? Still side by side, gridlock at the front of the field. Lynch in the 76, going to rotate off the corner, and he will lead the first lap. Teammates running side by side, second and third. Gio Ruggiero, 22, William Swalich in the two, and then the point leader into the fifth spot. It is Casey Roderick ahead of Ronald Ballard. Dale Sarks just sorted out, spread out a little bit, 100 laps tonight. You can't win it this early in the race, but you sure as heck can lose it. Racing hard with Nicholas Nava, fourth position inside the top 10. Good clean start to this event. James Lynch, show the leader. Connor Mozak, Billy Van Meter side by side. Use the 112 as a pick. Here comes Bubba Powder. Some hard racing. Agmt's going to try to bring the 22 machine. Doesn't make the opening of Max Fairway, so we'll watch the 22. Big lead for James Lynch. And that blue number 76 way out ahead of Stevie Nassi. Nick White's machine crawling along the bottom of turns 3 and 4. Brad Bain trying to make a move on the 08 to Nicholas Knottle. Looks like the 22 of Nick White is going to make it off. The Speedway will stay green. Casey Roderick all over the back of Williams Wallach in corner two. Side by side, Roderick inside of the two and Swalich. Casey Roderick going to get through. Swalich going to power up and pound into the back bumper. Casey Roderick under attack by Donnie Wilson calls today. William gets into it, pushing Casey Roderick up the track. Boy, oh boy. First it was the 22, now it's the 2. So all it's going to no room. Here comes Bubba Pollard now, the 26 into the mix. Casey Roderick, the boy that are under attack tonight. And Roderick goes and gives just a little up tap to William Swalich, who powers up. Dave Sommers right behind them, going to make a move on the inside of the 22. Sommers rolling forward. Lynch in lap traffic again, my heart. Oh, look at this! The 2 and the 18 all over each other. Oh, man. William Swalich. Oh, Casey Roderick was smart. He moved up. You can see the 2 trying to gas up and get him. Oh, boy, hold your breath in turn 3. Swalich with a nose inside. Thinks better of it. Things cool for the moment. Roderick up to 3rd. Traffic ahead. Haven't seen too much of rivalries this week. There's been things here and there. Will Swalich gets to him again. 17th lap car down the bottom of the race track. Field accelerates off the corner. Swalich is within striking distance. Another little love tap perhaps in the front stretch. All this going on behind the James Lynch. 26 laps complete. Some good racing going on right now. Some wild stuff out there. He still hangs on the second. Casey Roderick trying to break free of this Donnie Wilson brigade. They took swings at him and nothing landed. Brushing back his eyebrows perhaps, but other than that, Roderick holds a steady wheel. And the point leader is free on a closing on Stephen Massey. And 76 has led from the get-go. 28 complete. Bubba Pollard over the inside of Williams Wallace. That'll be fourth or fourth position. The Donnie Wilson car is fading here under this long green run to start the race. Connor Mozak under the 08 Nicholas Knottle, who's got the left front brake rotors going. Again to the back bumper, the 18 of Casey Roderick. Roderick is not quite going to have a good way. Here goes Pollard down to the bottom. Pollard trying to get that fourth spot on the two of Swalich. Bubba Pollard, William Swalich, side by side for fourth on turn 4. Pollard in the 26. Trying to gas it up. And he is clear of Swalich. side. Pollard and Roderick still the best ball on track. Roderick with a power move off the corner. Pollard and Roderick continue the battle on world position. Final spot up on the podium. That's all right now. All of this going on. James Lynch storming away in the front of the field. Settle their groove for a minute. Pollard up to the third spot now. So Alex to the inside of Casey Roderick for that bottle heat back up. Alex on the inside of Roderick giving him room. The 18 starting to fade. Long run here. 38 laps in the books. Great racing going on throughout the field. Even with a big lead for the 76, this one's been action-packed. William Swartz in the 2. Trying to get a run on Casey Roderick's number 18. Casey Roderick under attack again from that 2 sheet. So Roderick gives him very little room. And as they battle, here comes Gabe Sommers. Sommers with a good run going tonight. Sommers drops to the bottom. Patrick Thomas, two-pit road in at it. Roderick going to hang on to the fifth position for now. Gabe Sommers going to put the pressure on. Now heating up for second. Man, James Lynch looking like Sean Bass out there right now. Eight laps shy of a halfway point. Gabe Sommers going to work on the championship leader. Sommers and Roderick side by side for position. Beginning to fade now in front of 18. So dominant. A couple of wins on the week. But a 22-point lead over Giovanni Ruggiero. Almost insurmountable at this point. It would need 12 positions. Still possible. But Roderick would need a nightmare situation to happen. Battle for second brewing. Number 26, Bubba Power. Looking at that country with 51 of Steven Massey. Max Fairway, the yellow and green numbers. James Lynch in turn 3, second place off turn number 2. James Lynch has nailed the setup tonight. Can he hang on? Will it last? Well, Pollard putting the pressure on Steven Massey. Pollard probably thinks he's going for the lead right now. I'm sure keeping him abreast of the situation. But what it is, Steven Nassar and Bubba Pollard side by side into turn 1. Pollard, white 26 down on the inside. Steven Nassar machine with black roof up on the outside. So Wallach behind the 15 of Gabe Sommers. Second through fifth, nose to tail down the front straightaway. Lappers side by side. Trying to get it sorted out. Weaver falls to the bottom, giving room to these lead cars. Here's your leader, James Lynch, by the way, down the front straightaway. One lap shy, halfway. Got the ball clear to the second position. As we're halfway home, the Orange Blossom 100, James Lynch, the leader, by a straightaway. Oh, look out! Casey Roderick gets into him, the 17, up into the air! Yellow flag is out. The rookie Trenton Heinrich goes around. up into the wall, into the air he goes. Including your point leader, Casey Roderick, the 17 calls of the night. The 18, Casey Roderick, making a move down to the bottom of the racetrack. Your point leader on pit road after contact with the 17. The 17, from what I could see there, was doing what he was supposed to do, and Roderick kind of drove through the grass and around went the 17, and now the Anthony Campy racing number 18, your point leader to pit road. Second place point man is Giovanni Ruggiero. He need to win the race at this point for the championship to come into jeopardy. Looks like they're going to get that 18 car back out on the racetrack. He's going to give Bubba Pollard the outside. James Lynch has been the leader all the way. And here they come. Lynch, inexperienced versus Bubba Pollard with all the experience in the world. Backing away and look at the 76. He's going to climb the hill. Here we go. Stacking up off two. Middle leader, William Swalich. James Lynch pedaled it a little too hard. Here comes Gabe Somers up to third. William Swalich to the lead at halfway. Contact for the back of the field. Mozak and Ruggiero getting into it. Lynch trying to get back up on the wheel. He said way up the racetrack. And we're lucky he didn't stack up three or four cars. Steven Massa, the big loser on that restart. He's fading backwards now. He's losing touch with the leaders. Brad Maida is outside. What a field stacking back up. New leader is William Swalich, winner on the opening race night for the Super 8s on Sunday. Battle for second brewing. Bubba Pollard looking at the bottom of the racetrack. Lynch is going high. And Bubba Pollard gets the drive off. William Swalich out in front, side by side for second. James Lynch in the 76 had that huge lead. Now Mike can start to overdrive a bit. Had to overcompensate from the restart. He's trying to hold off Bubba Pollard as he does that. William Swalich begins to scoot away. Enter tonight some 44 points back, not going to be able to make that up to the championship out of the question. Just wants the Orange Blossom 100 trophy. James Lynch slipping back to third spot now as Bubba Pollard gets by. Those are the top two on the restart. William Swalich able to take advantage of the 76 car. And you got to wonder if maybe James being out in front, knowing any better, used up his equipment getting out to that big lead, but right now he's not able to hold these guys out. Lynch now trying to hold off for Somers, who has a run. Somers looks down the bottom of the racetrack. Second place finishes in the last two races for William. But he can see that white number 26 car getting close, going forward, leading during the Kleinhardt Memorial earlier this week before a punch problem took him out. Stephen Massey filled him. Here comes the 28. Connor Ozak battles Stephen Massey for position. Casey Roderick comes back down on the ground. John Kaufman still in the pit area. Again, still working on Steve Weaver's machine as Roderick is set to return, and this time he'll catch the tail of the field. A lot of inside selections during this year's World Series. Bubba Pollard will restart on the outside. Gabe Sommers down the inside third. James Lynch, the early leader, fourth. Brad May, Connor Mozak, your top 6 field stack, and up 35 laps to go, back and away. Top 2 in a jump, second row, flagging back just a little bit there, and around goes Van Meter. Yellow flag is out. Everybody on the binders. Van Meter goes around, didn't hit anything. Roderick able to get it started. I don't know who's going to win. James Lynch dominated early. Now it's William Swalich and Bubba Pollard in control. Gabe Sommer sitting back there in third, looking for his first World Series win. Let's see what's going to happen this time. Back at it. 35 remain. A bit better looking restart. Not quite as stacked up this time. Pollard in the 26. Swalich down on the bottom. Pollard who knows out in front. William going to try to use the bottom side of the racetrack the shorter way around. More momentum on that high side. Bubba Pollard out in front by half a car. Swalich up the hill and frees Bubba. Bubba Pollard to the front. Swalich going to try to fight back now. Bubba Pollard though able to hang on to it. Oh, a little twitch. He's loose. Swalich going to get a run. It's not done yet. And Swalich almost into the quarter panel in turn number one. Looked like Swalich tried to take a straight shot going into the corner, and it did not pay off. Bubba Pollard back out in front, half of the car, trying to win the Orange Blossom 100. Casey Roderick and Gio Ruggiero going at it again. Keep it on the 18 and the 22. Gio Ruggiero up the hill, following Casey Roderick, getting into him again. Man, oh man, Casey Roderick. Some worse for Extreme Dwelling at Adelaide. On this restart, Roderick ahead of Ruggiero, so there go any championship implications. Roderick has it in hand at this point. Bubba Pollard leads us to lap 70, 30 to go.
James Lynch.
76 brings it to pit road. Nonetheless, a great World Series for this young kid. How about Casey Roderick back up to sixth now in the 18, almost got a piece of the fence. Roderick slicing up through the field. He is now in sixth position trying to chase down Connor Mozak. To close out the World Series with his fourth quarter win. Williams Wallach in the two. Looking for his second career win. Started it off the win. Now Stephen Nassie's got problems on the back straightaway. Here we go again with the mechanical stuff. A slew of mechanical problems during the Fine Memorial, and now it's starting to take a hold again. James Lynch shuts down. Stephen Nassie shuts down. The battle for lead, still a good one. Bubba Pollard, 26. Williams Wallach, 2. So Wallach with a run. Contact, throw down the main straightaway. So Wallach on the bottom. Bubba Pollard around the outside. He's on the lead. Charge from William Swalich. Gabe Sommers sitting back in third and love to see those two get into it. Gabe Sommers having hit it. That's run out of the weekend by far. Last year had a great World Series going through a motor halfway through the week. Best finish so far for Gabe is sixth back on the 12th. He's looking better back at his first top five run. A little inconsistent for Gabe Sommers this series. Sixth, 14th, 8th, 12th, and 7th. They're coming along his way. Field beginning to thin out just a little bit. A yellow flag that certainly picks up the pack one more time. Leaders catching the leader machine will pull over on the back straightaway and up and go. DJ Duke battling with Nicholas Noggle. Noggle's been off the pace a little bit here today. Noggle was fifth last time out 2 nights ago. Outside of the top 10 today. Noggle is actually 10th, correct Ben. He's still inside the top 10. Austin Terrace having his best run in 8th at 29 car. Hasn't been the fastest pace out here this week, but battled hard all weekend. Might get the driver out of Maine. Top 10 at North Crossing 100 as they run right now. For the lead, Williams Swalich continues to shove the nose right for that bumper of Bubba Pollard. Oh, Nicholas Noggle's off the pace. Another one. Going by the dust here. 10th place car. They are dropping like flies. Who's going to be left? 15 to go, our last car running. Well, that'll move the Van Meter machine up to the 10th spot. Two-car breakaway at the front. Gabe Sommers back in third. Brad May is fourth, Connor Mozak fifth. James Wallace on the roll the top side of the racetrack to get some momentum. Can't quite get it built up. Racing with the top spot on the Orange Blossom 100. So Wallace stuff for 10 to go. Pollard now dives low. That'll put Pollard up there. Swalich in that preferred groove. And he's going to try to pull away. William Swalich legging it out on the back straightaway. Connor Pollard driving hard and got him 26th, trying not to let the two machine go. William Swalich wrestles the lead away from Bubba Pollard. First, third, 23rd, second, and second. A great week for this kid. He'll come up short in the championship to Casey Roderick. And man, he could lead here. Orange Blossom 100 winner. Field is pretty well spread out. A caution would certainly make it interesting, but we're inside of 10 to go, and Bubba Pollard is fading. William Swalich, you'll remember the name for sure. Swalich got a run on the Arca Tour this season for good racing. Orange Blossom 100s in recent memory. Great battles throughout the field. Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner out of the car. Make some noise for William Swalich in car number two. Wow, what a week for you. You started things off on Sunday with a win. You had some great matches throughout the week. One hiccup in the Clyde Hart Memorial. You rebound tonight, winning probably one of the most thrilling Orange Blossom 100s we've had in a long time. Congratulations.
Thank you. I appreciate it. It was a really fun race. I can't thank the Donnie Wilson crew enough for giving me this great car. I worked hard all week to get to this point, and I can't thank Mobile One, TRD, and Soundgear, and Starkey.
Well, it has been a long week. It's been a grind. You did this with the Pro Late Models last year, and now you come out your first World Series with a Super Late Model, and you had some stunning results. Did you have a good time here this week through all of this?
For sure. This is going to be a highlight of the year for me, so I had a great time.
Well, you have some big things coming up this year. Tell everybody what you'll be doing the rest of the year.
Yeah, I'll be doing 20 ARCA races with Joe Gibbs Racing, six Craftsman Truck Series races with Tricon, and a bunch of late model races.
Well, William, congratulations on a great week, and congratulations on becoming the Orange Blossom 100 winner.
Thank you.
William Swallis, your winner tonight. Keep your eyes on this kid. He'll be doing a lot of racing this year, and you'll see him on your TV. Well, Bubba, not the race you wanted on Tuesday in the Clyde Hart Memorial. You were leading that thing when a part took you out. Tonight you have a battle with William Swallis. Tell us about the battle there, because he raced you hard, or in my eyes, raced you clean.
Yeah, that's the way it's supposed to be. You know, this place is tough to... tough to pass. He was a little bit better than I was. I was trying to do all I could do to protect. There's a hell of a fireworks show, right?
Yeah, it's going crazy over there.
But, it was a lot of fun racing with these guys. Just come out. We had a good car Tuesday night. I just tightened it up tonight and just got way too tight. I should have left it how it run Tuesday night, and I think we'd have been fine. But, yeah, it's fun racing those guys. We just go on and try it again in here in a couple weeks.
Well, as always, we appreciate you coming out here, being part of the World Series. You're a fan favorite out here, so anytime there's 26 cars here, the fans show up, so we appreciate you.
No, yeah, I know it's been a long week on some of these guys and some of these fans and stuff, so, thanks for all those fans coming out, and hopefully we'll put on a good show.
Bubba, thanks for being here. Bubba Pollard brings it home with a second place run here tonight. You might be able to hear this one. Gabe Somers, hey, bud, great run tonight. Good to see you up here on the podium. This team has fought hard all week. You know, you've had some good runs, but to get up on the podium on the last night, one of the biggest races of the week, that's got to send you out of here with some good confidence.
Yeah, for sure. We were struggling with the car all week, and I don't know if it was the modified tire that was screwing us up all week. It just didn't have the drive we needed, and it rained last night, and we unloaded with a good car and adjusted on a little bit all day today, and ended up on the podium, so I'm really happy about that.
Well, last year you ran well, too. Engine problems took you out. So at least this year you're able to finish this thing off. And like I said to everybody else, we appreciate you guys coming all this way to support the World Series.
Yeah, thank you.
Anybody you'd like to thank?
Yeah, I'd like to thank Waisaki Produce Farms, Rowdy Energy, Wisconsin Potatoes, and all my guys. They've been working really hard all week.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's here for Gabe Somers. A great third-place run for car number 15. Casey, come on over here. We have the World Championship Trophy to deliver to you. I know this is not the result you wanted here tonight, but you're going to come away a champion. You had a great week, picked up a couple of wins. This car was fast. Man, you tore through the field there at the end.
Yeah, we just we suffered a brake line issue. You know, just couldn't get in the corner like we were. And, you know, after I passed the two there, we were you know, just going to buy our time. And, you know, I had a really fast race car. Just... a couple laps after I passed the two, it just pedal went straight to the floor with no warning. So found out later that we had a line that came loose on the right rear. So suffered with no brakes the rest of the race, and it is what it is. That's why we race. It's just part of it. But I'm really proud of everyone that's worked so hard all week long. It's been a long week. It's very tiring, so they worked their butts off to get me a World Series championship and some wins. And I want to thank Platinum Express for everything they've done, and hopefully we can continue the rest of the year like this. So looking forward to it, and you know, it just I hate tonight happened the way it did, but it is what it is.
Well, you had the best week of anybody out here. You're not the only guy to not have any major problems. I know the brakes tonight, but still, to finish sixth, your first time down here to the World Series, did you think it was going to go this well?
I knew coming into it we had a shot. You know, every race I've entered so far with Platinum, Team Platinum and Team ACR, we've been very strong and have a chance to win. So we just got to keep digging and go to these other races, do the same thing we did this week.
And what's the plan for this team? Are you guys sticking together and run some of the big tour races?
Yeah, I hope so. We'll just have to see how the year goes. We got a couple more races planned so far, but after that, I'm not sure of right now.
Well, Casey, congratulations. Thanks for coming down. Casey Roderick, our champion for the David Rogers Super Late Models in the World Series in 2023. And anytime that team shows up, that's a potent combination. we'll let the interviews wrap up here, and we'll get ready for the Super Stock 50 Lapper, one of my favorite local divisions out here, so it should be a fun way to end it. Two races to go.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.